A function g is called an antiderivative of a function f on an interval if the derivative of g with respect to x is equal to f of x for every point x in that interval. The process of finding the antiderivatives of a function is called antidifferentiation. For example, if a function g is defined as x squared minus 4x plus 3, then its derivative is 2x minus 4. If the function f is 2x minus 4, then f is the derivative of g, and g is an antiderivative of f. If another function h is defined as x squared minus 4x minus 1, then f is also the derivative of h, and h is also an antiderivative of f. So all of the functions x squared minus 4x plus 3, x squared minus 4x minus 1, x squared minus 4x plus 7, x squared minus 4x plus pi, and x squared minus 4x plus 7 over 2, which differ only by a constant term, are antiderivatives of f. We can express all of the antiderivatives of f, or the general antiderivative of f, as x squared minus 4x plus c, where c is any real number. Graphically, the antiderivatives of f represent vertical translations of the same function, differing only by the value of the constant term c. Below are the graphs of five members of the family of antiderivatives of 2x minus 4, where c is equal to 3, negative 1, 7, negative pi, and 7 over 2. The general antiderivative of 2x minus 4 is x squared minus 4x plus an arbitrary constant for all x, provided that the derivative of that general antiderivative is equal to 2x minus 4 for all x. The general antiderivative of a function on an interval is called the indefinite integral of the function on that interval, and is written using an elongated S called an integral symbol. Given a function, there is exactly one antiderivative of the function that passes through a given point in the xy plane. For example, let's find the function f, whose derivative is x minus 2 for all x, and passes through the point 0, 3. Any function f that has the form half x squared minus 2x plus a constant c will have a derivative equal to x minus 2, so the general antiderivative of x minus 2 is half x squared minus 2x plus c. In symbols, the function f of x is equal to the indefinite integral of x minus 2, which is equal to half x squared minus 2x plus c. Since we're given that f has the value 3 when x is equal to 0, substitute 0 for x in the expression for f, find the value of c, and the specific function that is both an antiderivative of x minus 2 and passes through 0, 3. Substituting x equals 0, we get half times 0 squared minus 2 times 0 plus c, which is c. So c is equal to 3. And the specific antiderivative is half x squared minus 2x plus 3. Antidifferentiation formulas take the guesswork out of the process of finding antiderivatives. The antiderivative of 1 is x plus c. Checking by differentiating the result, the derivative of x plus c is 1. The antiderivative of any constant k is k times x plus c, or kx plus c. Checking, the derivative of kx plus c is k. This next one is called the power rule, which says that the antiderivative of x to the nth is x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c, which is valid for all x, provided that n is not equal to negative 1. If n is equal to negative 1, using the formula would give us a 0 in the denominator. We will look into how to deal with the case of n equal to negative 1 in another anicast in this series. Checking, the derivative of x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c can be written as the sum of two separate derivatives. The first, the derivative of x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1, and the second, the derivative of the constant c. For the first, n plus 1, the exponent of x, cancels with the n plus 1 in the denominator, and the exponent of x is then reduced by 1, and the derivative of the constant c is just 0, which leaves x to the n. To find an antiderivative of a sum or difference of functions, find antiderivatives of the two functions separately, then add or subtract the results. This formula is valid provided that both functions are defined on the same interval. For example, the antiderivative of x minus x cubed is equal to the antiderivative of x minus the antiderivative of x cubed. Applying the power rule, for the first we have x squared over 2, and x to the fourth over 4 for the second. There is a constant c added to the result, which represents the sum of constants from the first and second antiderivatives. Checking, the derivative of half x squared minus a quarter x to the fourth is equal to x minus x cubed. Similar to the last formula, the antiderivative of a sum or difference of a finite number of functions is the sum or difference of the antiderivatives of the individual functions. This formula is valid provided that all of the functions are defined on the same interval. There are also antidifferentiation formulas for trigonometric functions. I will go over a few of them here. The antiderivative of sine of x is the negative of the cosine of x plus c. Checking, the derivative of the negative of the cosine of x plus c is equal to the negative of the negative of sine of x, or just sine of x. The antiderivative of cosine of x is sine of x plus c. Checking, the derivative of sine of x plus c is equal to cosine of x. The antiderivative of secant squared of x is tangent of x plus c. Checking, the derivative of tangent of x plus c is equal to secant squared of x. The antiderivative of secant of x times tangent of x is secant of x plus c. Checking, the derivative of secant of x plus c is equal to secant of x times tangent of x. The antiderivative of cosecant squared of x is the negative of cotangent of x plus c. Checking, the derivative of the negative of the cotangent of x plus c is equal to the negative of the negative cosecant squared of x, or just cosecant squared of x. The antiderivative of cosecant of x times cotangent of x is the negative of cosecant of x plus c. Checking, the derivative of the negative of cosecant of x plus c is equal to the negative of the negative of cosecant of x times the cotangent of x, or just cosecant of x times cotangent of x. In future anicasts in this series, we will discuss other antidifferentiation formulas.